Good Saturday morning, everyone. I need to share this because I think we all go through these moments throughout our journey. And I think the one downfall, and not a bad way, because it does push us, but one downfall of this community. Good morning, Ashley. Happy Saturday. The one downfall of this community is that we tend to want to, quote unquote, keep up with the Joneses. We want to do what we see others doing. What we see is transforming them, and we may be feeling stuck. And I was feeling stuck. And it has been something that I've been wrestling with the past 2 weeks and debating, if I choose to deviate, does that mean I am a failure? Does that mean that I am giving up on you that may have looked towards me for inspiration, for direction, to decide what makes the most sense for you? So I'm thinking of myself as a failure if I choose to deviate. But in the same respect, we are in this community for bigger and better reasons. We are part of this community because we want more. We want more out of life. We want more fun in our journey. We want community. And by having this community, I think that we need to hug one another and know that whatever we choose is best for us, we need to celebrate. We need to cheer each other on. We need to continue pushing forward. So I was in the mindset of, I want to give up. This isn't fun for me. This is something that I struggle with doing every single day. And right now, with the struggle of actually getting up and out of bed due to my thyroid fatigue, it is really a struggle. And I have to take myself back 8+ years ago when I was that glorified gym rat, when I was that person that would get up at the butt crack of dawn, drive myself to the gym before the doors even opened so I could be first in line for that class that I loved, for that instructor that I loved, for that energy rush, because I knew at the end of that class period, whether it be one classes, two classes, or more, yes, I was that insane. Don't have the time for that or energy these days, but back then, I looked forward to that sweat. I looked forward to the energy. I looked forward to the music. I looked forward to the power of the instructor on that microphone and what she spilled into me that I could apply to my day. So, taking that mentality, and that is the person I've always been. That is what got me into Beachbody. That is what drove my passion to become a coach. That is what inspires me every day to serve my purpose, to help all of you find your stride, to find your energy, to find your light, so that you truly enjoy this journey. So to go back to who I truly was and have always been, because fitness is my thing. It is my thing. But when I am not motivated and when I am not inspired, it is such a struggle, because that is the one thing that I look forward to every day. And I haven't been looking forward to my workouts, which sucks. And I would look towards all of you for inspiration to just do it. If they can do it, I can do it. And that is what this community is about. But at the same respect, it is us in our homes doing what we need to do. And we need to be inspired by what is on our TV or our computer every single day, because it is that driving force that helps us to push play. So with that all being said, I only hope that you hear what I'm saying to continually apply to your journey. Because if something isn't working for you, then close the chapter on that book. Shelf it for another time, because there may be another season of your life that it makes the most sense for. But for me, Morning Meltdown 100 is not cutting it for me right now. It isn't. I don't know what it is, because the music's fantastic. The moves are just what I love. I love the challenging new moves, but I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's Jericho not speaking truth into me every day. I don't know. I can't put my finger on it. But just like I would have done if I was going to the gym, if the instructor's not doing it for me, if the class isn't doing it for me, if the music's not doing it for me, I'm out. And I have walked out of classes before when I was at the gym, because I just wasn't moved, and I would go do something else that would give me that energy. So this morning I was like, you know what? Enough is enough, because this isn't doing it for me. And though we were all in this together, and though I don't want to give up on those of you that are doing Morning Meltdown, it just isn't doing it right for me. And it may be perfect for you. It may be awesome for you. And I love that. I absolutely love that. And the thing about nowadays, when I started coaching, you didn't know about programs until you heard it from me. But now with the power of Beachbody on Demand and emails and the blog, you know about the programs at the same time that I do. And we're all experiencing it together. But for me, it's not doing it. So I'm closing the book, I'm shelving it, and I'm doing what needs to be done. And the man that speaks the truth and speaks life and began this entire journey 7 years ago was Mr. Sean T. And I know many of you love him in this community. And I am going back and tackling Transform 20 100%, because when this came out, if you guys weren't with me at that time, I was pregnant with Marin. So I was modifying a lot. I couldn't go all out. And as much as it was struggle, Ashley, yes, I love you, girl. Thank you. But the man does it for me. I literally was crying with him at the end of the workout on day one. And I've done this before. I've gone through it. But it just proves to me that his truth and his words and his motivation speak life into my soul right now for what I need and for what the struggles I am going through. The man does it for me. I don't know. I always love him, and I'm doing it now because this is what my life needs. This is the season what I am in, so I can power through and be stronger than my circumstances right now. And what he said is that we all have wants and we all have needs, but the needs are non-negotiable. And my need right now is him. My need right now is all of you. And those two forces combined make this journey epic. And I hope that you guys do the same. If you are struggling today, if you are not feeling it, if you are not motivated, look towards other ways to bring it. Maybe it's the workout. Maybe it's the instructor. Maybe it's the time of day. Maybe it's the music. If it's the music, put some headphones on. I did that tons of times in my workouts. If it's not the instructor, then ask me, ask someone else in the community, because someone is going to speak the truth into your soul every day and pump you up and get fired. Maybe it's the time of day you're working out. Look at all of your moments of your day, your circumstances. What do you need in your life? So please, I only hope that this inspires you rather than gets you mad that I am deviating, but this is what it's about, you guys. It's our journeys, and we got to live it and love it and keep doing it so that we do keep doing it, because it needs to become a lifestyle. It is a lifestyle that you look forward to, that becomes natural, that just becomes a part of you. And if you don't have that, then you know your day is off. And my life didn't have him right now, and my day was off. But now I am so amped freaking up, and I'm ready to tackle this weekend. Love you, Abby. Thank you for all your support. Love you. So that is where I'm at right now, you guys. Look at your life. Look at what it needs right now. We are coming to an end of another month. We have a little more than a full week left of September, and we're rolling into October. A lot of fun fall things coming at you, but think about where you are. If what you are currently doing is not feeding your soul, then you decide, what do you need? What is going to make it better? What is going to make you look forward to your workouts every day? Okay? If you need help in figuring this out, hey, talk in the group here. We are here to help you. I am here to help you. We are in this together, and it's about the joy of the journey. All right? Love you all. Happy weekend. Let's do this.